this video, we will start with general angles. You will find this on page 171 in the Namibia AS-Level Mathematics book Y equals mx plus c to success. General angles. In the Cartesian plane, the x and the y axes divide the plane into four quadrants. Consider the line OP, O is the origin, B is a point on the plane. Notice the positive, remember it's anti-clockwise, and negative clockwise rotation from the positive x-axis. So if you go around like this, it's positive, and if you go around like this, it's a negative angle. The table below shows four examples where OP rotates in an anti-clockwise direction. The values of theta are positive, but notice the difference between the angle theta and beta. Beta is the angle to the x-axis. Okay, so I think I'm going to make it a bit bigger. You can see better. Keep it like this. Okay. So basically, the first one, if beta, okay, so this is 50 and beta is 15 because it's just up to there. But this one is 130 theta because it's from this x, from the point there, I start counting. So that's 90, that's 180, that's 270, and that's 360. So this will be theta, the golden one, but the angle towards the x-axis, beta, will be 50. Okay. This one, 230, so I pass 180, and if I say 230 minus 1, I see that the angle towards the x-axis is 50. And then 310, that's theta, but the angle towards the x-axis is 50. So beta is always a positive acute angle between the line OP and the x-axis, the shortest row to that. The angle beta can also be another symbol. You can use any symbol. It's known as the basic acute angle or reference angle. Okay, so that's why I called it beta. Now let's look at these examples. Draw each of the following angles on the Cartesian plane. Indicate clearly the direction of rotation and find the basic angle beta. 250. Now 250 will be between 180 and 270. So it will be there. So just say 250 minus 180 and I see 70. So beta will be 70. Okay. So 180 plus 70 will be 250. Or otherwise, if you want to find it, just say in this case 250 minus 180 and you get the 70. Now this one is more than 360. Do you see that? So actually, again, I can just subtract 360 and then I get 130. Oh, 130 will be between 90 and 180 there. And again, if I say 180 minus 130, I get 50. So beta is 50. And then this one, now I'm not in degrees, I'm in radians. So remember, this is a half pi, this is pi, this is 1.5, and this is 2 pi. So if I have 1 and 1 over 8, so it's a little bit over, and I say, again, I can, I think it's actually, I'll express it like this, which is correct, but I think sometimes you can just take that and subtract pi, and you also come to that answer. Okay. I want you to stop the video, and I'm going to make it a bit bigger, that you see better. And I want you just to do try now 90. I think if I give you, no, I think do all three, because in this case, it will be all different. This is more than a revolution. This is in terms of radians. Okay, but let's start. So if I make a picture, and every time, okay, I think I'm going to make my three pictures. Okay. I can make this as A. Oh, let's get my pen correct. This is A. This is B. This is C. Okay. So 220. Now, 220, remember, this is 0. This is 90. This is 180. This is 270. So where is 220? 220, if I make it yellow, and I keep to my ruler, say 220 is say there. So, and that will now save me, for example, my point B. So I must find that angle, beta. So there's Cartesian indicator direction, find the basic angle. So all that I said, I think in a previous example, though it was written, I can maybe just go and say 220 to find beta. It's 220 minus 180. And that will be, so beta, so therefore, beta will be equal to 40 degrees. And the thing is why I write it like that, because we will later use that expression more, where we say 180, so beta, not beta, 220, where we express 220 will be 180 plus 40. We're going to use this expression a lot, and that's why it's good that you get used to this type of writing. Okay, but the next one, 520. So now, I must actually just make my small sum. And I will say, okay, if I say 520, and I subtract 360, I get 160. So that is just my calculation. But if I write it, okay, now look how I write it. I'm going to say 520 is equal to 360 plus, let's just move a little bit. Yeah, I can move up to it. 360 plus that 160, but the 160 can be broken up into 180 minus 20 degrees. Okay, but at the end, if I want that, I want the angle towards, so because so this one is going to be, it's going to make a revolution, 360, and then it's going to make 160 up to there. So actually, and I'm going to use a red line now, I'm looking for this angle, and this angle will just be 20 degrees. So therefore, beta is just that 20 degrees. Okay, but it helps if you, but get used to writing it in this way. Then the last one, and don't forget now I'm in radians. And if I'm in radians, I must remember this is pi, and if I come around, it's 2 pi, but it also starts at 0. And this is pi over 2, and this is 3 over 2 pi. So in this case, if I must write, so if I'm making my own calculation here, and I'm going to say 13 pi over 6. Now first simplify this. So if you simplify that fraction, you will get 2 and 1 over 6 pi. So 2 pi meaning that it's making a full revolution. Okay, and then it makes 1 over 6, and that's less than, so it's then going up to there. So, I have so many colors now. So, basically, I can still write it here for myself. It's 2, 1 over 6 pi minus 2 pi. So, it's actually that 1 over 6 pi. That's beta. Okay. But if I want to write it now in the way which I want you to get used to, I'm going to say 13 over 6 pi will be equal to the 2 pi plus 1 6 pi. 1 6 over pi. Therefore, beta is equal to pi over 6. Get used to this, because this is a preparation of what we're going to do later.